Our coffee breaks with researchers aim to spread knowledge about regional development and innovation. By sending a camera around the world, we present you with different angles and insights on the topic. We ask researchers directly and in a personal manner about their work. We want to make scientific knowledge accessible to all.
Hi, welcome to Coffee Break with Researchers. Today, I'm having a coffee break with Danny MacKinnon. He is a professor of regional development and governance and director of CURTS, Center of Urban and Regional Development Studies at the University of Newcastle in the United Kingdom. Hello, Danny. Thank you for accepting our invitation to a coffee break. How are you doing?
I'm doing good, thanks.
I'm having today a Vietnamese black coffee. Which one are you having?
Also having a black coffee in my new Coffee Break with Researchers mug.
Great. In a recent paper, you rethink how regional paths are created and put it in a more global context. Could you please tell me the main idea of the paper?
In the context of a lot of research being done on path creation and evolutionary economic geography, the field we're working within in recent years, a lot of empirical research, case study research, but at least when we started writing the paper, there didn't seem to be a synthesis which was bringing all this research together. So that was the first idea, but the need to kind of synthesize and bring together this kind of flourishing range of research on path creation in recent years. And secondly, the second main idea is about the need for what we saw as a need for a more integrated systematic framework for thinking about regional path creation in terms of its kind of key constituent aspects and dimensions and the relationships between them. So it's about making implicit perhaps some of the concepts and criteria that were being used in case study research, not least by ourselves in the work we were doing on renewable energy.
This sounds fascinating. And which ones were the main arguments of the paper?
It's a theoretical paper, so it's very much at the level of arguments. It's not presenting empirical research. But there were three main arguments, I think. First of all, that operating in the context of kind of multi-level institutional environments, so linking the local, regional, national, and supranational, that key regional actors predominantly could be public, private, civic actors. A basis for path creation is their efforts to identify, harness and valorize specific regional and indeed extra-regional assets. So we define assets in terms of five types, from natural assets, resources, institutional material assets, industrial assets, human assets like skills, and institutional assets. The second key argument is that kind of path creation depends on these actors linking, matching, what we call strategically coupling these assets to broader mechanisms of path creation, principally diversification, transplantation, attracting new investment from outside, and kind of indigenous path creation, growth from within. And thirdly, it's this strategic coupling or matching between the assets and mechanisms and associated markets that ultimately gives the momentum and direction to path creation and kind of reproduces it and kind of expands the regional economy, I guess. So these were the main arguments.
This was a very comprehensive and ambitious project. What was your main motivation in doing the paper?
Well, I've been going back. I think we originally came up with a framework in the context of a research proposal in, I think, early 2013. So the paper was quite a long time in the writing. Lay there for a while before we actually picked it up and resubmitted it. Also, the context of previous papers, two other theoretical papers on or kind of intervening in evolutionary economic geography as a field. So all three ultimately been published in the journal Economic Geography. A 2009 paper which kind of engaged with what evolutionary economic geography was, and then a paper which came out in 2016 which was on kind of method and doing evolutionary economic geography. So in the context of these papers, this is obviously focused on path creation. I think we also, a lot of evolutionary economic geography debates had been focused on path dependence previously, and there'd been some kind of landmark theoretical papers written on path dependence by Ron Martin and Peter Sunley. So I think we kind of, there's an ambition to try and emulate them and write an equivalent paper on path creation. So I think that's partly where that came from.
Thank you very much for that. And are there some policy implications you can draw based on the paper?
Yeah, I mean, that's quite tricky for this paper because it's a kind of quite an abstract theoretical paper. But I think in very broad terms, in terms of how you think about regional development, the biggest thing probably is about the need to place regional development and the harnessing of regional assets to stimulate growth, create new paths, diversify, needing to put that in the context of wider economic processes, what we call mechanisms of path creation, so diversification, transplantation, attracting inward investment, even indigenous creation. But it's about ensuring that the harnessing of regional assets is kind of geared towards linking broader economic processes and targeting growth markets beyond the region, attracting investment from outside. We have a PhD student who worked as an economic development practitioner for probably about 30 years, and he's kind of used this framework, and he's been quite attracted to the emphasis on external forces and extra regional connections, needing to put regional development in that context. I guess having been working under these constraints as a practitioner.
Thank you very much again, Danny, for the nice insights. It was a pleasure for me to have you here in a coffee break. I wish you all the best for your future research, and I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you for watching. If you're interested in more details about this research, find here the link to the academic publication. Thank you. See you next time. Bye-bye.